of our national security. Space is really important to our nation. It underpins everything that we do as a nation, either diplomatically, militarily, or economically.
The way that we fight the next major war is going to look very different from the way that we fought the last ones.
Liberty is freedom from authoritarianism.
For more than 75 years, the U.S. partnerships with like-minded allies have created an environment where all nations could thrive and prosper.
Communist China is the most pressing military threat, but America remains committed to avoiding war. To maintain peace, the U.S. has synchronized all six major military branches, which now includes the Space Force. On April 30th, the U.S. Secretary of Defense emphasized the government's objective.
Now, the cornerstone of America's defense is still deterrence, ensuring that our adversaries understand the folly of outright conflict. In the work that we do to keep the United States secure across all five domains of potential conflict, not just air and land and sea, but also space and cyberspace.
A photo of General Robert Briggs went viral. The viral photo shows the relaxed commander reclining with his feet propped up as he watches the Chinese aircraft carrier Liaoning nearby. His nonchalant demeanor has sparked widespread debate about the military strength of Communist China versus the United States.
In the Indo-Pacific must demonstrate the capability, the capacity, and the will to convince Beijing unequivocally the costs of achieving their objectives by the use of military force are simply too high. Make no mistake, the Communist Party of China seeks to supplant the idea of a free and open international order with a new order, one with Chinese characteristics, one where Chinese national power is more important than international law.
60% of world trade passes through this area of responsibility with 36 different countries and 52% of the world's population spanning 14 time zones.
As President John F. Kennedy said in 1961, only when our arms are sufficient beyond doubt can we be certain beyond doubt that they will never be employed.
But let me be clear, this competition does not have to put us on the road to conflict. Our number one job is to keep the peace. And to do that, we must be prepared to fight and win.
We are committed to providing the deterrence needed to prevent great power conflict. And should it be directed, we're committed to be able to fight tonight and win.
A malfunctioned Chinese rocket plummeted into the Indian Ocean nights ago. Fortunately, no one was killed. These incidents have brought great concern from the global community. The White House has called for, quote, responsible space behaviors. General John Raymond, the chief of space operations, has said Communist China's behavior in space has been under observation.
We saw that very visibly back in 2007 when they shot down one of their own satellites and created a debris field of about 3,000 pieces of debris that still remains in space today. China also has a satellite with a robotic arm on orbit that could grapple another satellite in the future. And China is developing cyber threats to hack our satellite systems. And it's not just China. Russia has similar capabilities as well.
On April 30th, General Raymond said that Space Force has taken the role of, quote, space traffic control. He continued, quote, our goal is to be responsible users of space, to be transparent in what we're doing to keep the domain safe for all, and limit the creation of debris in the first place.
In space, for example, integrated deterrence would mean ensuring that capabilities like our global positioning system can continue even if our adversaries attack it with missiles or cyber tools or space-based weapons. Integrated deterrence would also mean employing cyber effects in one location to respond to a maritime security incident hundreds of miles away.
The newly established Space Force has become one of the most important branches of the U.S. military. It has been in collaboration with 117 countries. The U.S. has launched over half of all satellites around the globe, ensuring a strong space defense system for America and the world. General David D. Thompson, said that Space Force has increased cooperation with private companies.
First of all, it's been 3 or 4 years now that we established the Space Enterprise Consortium. That consortium, the number of companies involved, the investment now about billions versus hundreds of millions and hundreds of companies continues to be that level.
In the crucial front of cyberspace, the U.S. military is increasing communication and synchronization across multi-domains.
I think this is really about the timing is right, and I have never seen more cooperation and agreement in not only the end state, but the pitch that we have in moving this forward. Timing could not be better.
The U.S. Army and Air Force signed a 2-year collaboration agreement in the development of the Combined Joint All-Domain Command and Control, or CJC2. In the CJC2 partnership, each of the military's 6 branches would connect sensors, shooters, and command nodes in a mesh network that would allow commanders more combat options and the ability to act faster.
The mesh network and the transport layer, the whole idea is to be able to move data as rapidly as possible to get that tactical information directly to the warfighter. So what the transport layer consists of are hundreds of satellites that form a resilient, optically interconnected mesh network that will pass data directly to existing tactical data lakes. So what that means to the warfighter is the following.
Yeah, there has been a lot of activity with using commercial partners, not only on like the Starlink, which is the AFRL program, to be able to show that they can tie into Starlink and then use that, essentially using a Starlink receiver to onboard a military platform.
The Department of State announced on April 20th that the United States cooperates with Singapore on a full range of security issues, including border security, maritime security, military preparedness, counter-proliferation, cybersecurity, and counterterrorism. According to the 2016 report, Securing the Energy Supply, China's Malacca Dilemma, 80% of China's oil imports have to pass through the Malacca Strait. The closest alternatives are the Straits of Lombok and Makassar, but they are 5 days slower. The heavily utilized, very large crude carriers also cannot safely navigate the Malaccan route. The UK plans to send its most powerful aircraft carrier, the HMS Queen Elizabeth, to the South China Sea for its first operational deployment. Japan's Defense Minister Nobuo Kishi announced on April 23rd that there would be a joint military drill with the U.S. and France to Japan's Southern Sea area in May. The Philippines and the U.S. launched 2 week-long military drills during the South China Sea tensions. Australia will soon spend $600 million on military bases to hold joint exercises with the United States.
In the long history of the world, only a few generations have been granted the role of defending freedom in its hour of maximum danger. I do not shrink from this responsibility. I welcome it.
The United States does not start fights. We will never be an aggressor. We maintain our strength in order to deter and defend against aggression, to preserve freedom and peace.
Thank you.